Hello, my name is Mandy Van Hoovlin, and I work in the Museum Learning and Programs Department at the Smithsonian's National Museum of the American Indian. Our museum has three locations. Our collections and archives are housed in the Cultural Resource Center in Suitland, Maryland. Our museum in New York is located in Lower Manhattan, and I work in our museum on the National Mall in Washington, D.C. And although we have three locations, we have just one vision: equity and social justice for the Native peoples of the Western Hemisphere through education, inspiration, and empowerment. The 2022 National History Day theme, Debate and Diplomacy, Successes, Failures, and Consequences, can be addressed in a variety of ways using the museum's exhibitions, online lessons, collections, and archives. Today I'll talk more about a vigorous debate that consumed the country in the early 1800s. The question was, should Indians be removed from the United States? The museum's exhibition, called Americans, explores the national debate surrounding Indian removal in the 1830s. Students can view the online exhibit at americanindian.si.edu/Americans. While the Indian Removal Act never mentions a single tribe or region, it was primarily aimed at the Cherokee, Muscogee Creek, Choctaw, Chickasaw, and Seminole nations because their sizable territories were amongst the most fertile lands in the South. The proposed place to remove Indians to was called Indian Territory and is now the state of Oklahoma. Supporters of Indian removal used economic arguments to justify the act. Wilson Lumpkin, the governor of Georgia from 1831 to 1835, was one of the fiercest advocates for the Indian Removal Act. He wanted a railroad built across Georgia land, hastening the state's economic progress. To make this happen, he needed land owned by the Cherokee. Lumpkin wrote of the long history of Georgia's relationship with the Cherokee Nation in his book, The Removal of the Cherokee Indians from Georgia. In it, he writes, "No man is fit to be a congressman who does not know that the government might have removed every Indian from Georgia." Opponents of removal argued for the inherent sovereign rights of Native nations. They claimed that expelling the entire Indian population of the United States went against existing policy and betrayed the democratic values of the country. Prominent voices against Indian removal disputed claims that Indian lands were destined for whites and that Indians lacked a, quote, civilized society. They recognized that American Indians had strong governments based on systems of morality and ethics that served their people's interests and shaped relationships with diverse outsiders, Native and non-Native alike. John Ross became the principal chief of the Cherokee Nation in 1827. Presiding over his nation during its fight against removal, he, along with other Native leaders, actively participated in the national debate. Ross staunchly opposed any proposal that the Cherokee cede their land because their nation was, quote, incompatible with the state of Georgia. Under Ross, the Cherokee established a constitutional form of government, allowed missionary schools into their territory, and established a bilingual tribal newspaper called the Cherokee Phoenix. He argued that any American unease about Cherokees was unjustified. While there were many vocal opponents of removal, most members of Congress were eventually persuaded that removal was in the best interests of American Indians. Ultimately, the Indian Removal Act passed by a margin of only 5 votes, and President Jackson signed it into law on May 28, 1830. This act and the removal of American Indians from the Deep South became Jackson's first major initiative as president. The work of removing Native nations spanned 9 presidencies and took approximately 25 years to complete. The policy resulted in the seizure of tens of millions of acres of Native land. Students can explore more in the museum's online lesson, What Does It Mean to Remove a People?, which is on our website at americanindian.si.edu/NK360. Different American Indian nations reacted to issues surrounding removal in different ways. This lesson shares the responses to difficult decisions that six different tribal leaders were faced with during removal and the consequences of those decisions. Native memories of removal have been passed on from generation to generation through stories, songs, and even personal names. In the early 1900s, Cherokee and Choctaw citizens popularized the phrase Trail of Tears. The name Trail of Tears first appeared in print in 1908 when used to describe Indian removal to Oklahoma. And while the process of removal created upheaval, suffering, and death among Indian people, it was not the end for American Indians. It's estimated that over 11,000 deaths resulted from removal. However, these tribal nations have survived and are even thriving as their own cultural and political entities today. In fact, the Cherokee Nation of Oklahoma is the largest federally recognized tribe in the United States today, with a population of more than 355,000 citizens. In this online resource, you can learn more about what the Cherokee did to rebuild their nation after removal. Indian removal contradicted democratic values. The act was ferociously debated, very expensive, and time-consuming. The consequences of removal forever shaped America's landscape and defined the future generations of those tribal members who faced it and survived. Today, we remember removal as a betrayal of American values. We should also not forget that it was thoughtfully debated by the most democratic country on earth at the time, supported by both political parties, and broadly accepted by its citizens. Students researching the Indian Removal Act of 1830 might explore the different historical figures involved, their arguments, and how these debates played out in the federal government's three branches, in different states, or even in local communities. You can access the National Museum of the American Indians collections, archives, and educational materials online at these websites. The National History Days 2022 theme book shares more resources and places to go to learn more about this debate in history. Good luck with your research.